Hello and welcome to the Sabre Limited demo series. Today we're going to be covering PrintVIS estimating, which is the PrintVIS MIS for Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central. A little bit about Sabre. Sabre Limited is a Dynamics 365 Business Central and Dynamics Nav training, implementation, and consulting specialist for small and medium businesses who are manufacturing companies anywhere throughout North America. PrintVIS is an MIS add-on for the Microsoft Dynamics NAV and Business Central ERP products, designed also for the small and medium printing industry. PrintVIS adds features to the existing Dynamics ERP system, preserving the features that are already there and enhancing them with print-specific solutions. When you buy PrintVIS, you also are receiving licenses for Microsoft Dynamics included in your purchase. Now, today we're going to look at the estimating capabilities of PrintVIS. If you haven't already watched the PrintVIS introduction demo that I did earlier, that would be quite helpful. Let's jump into PrintVIS. Here I am, I'm back in my role center. Watch the video that I've done on introduction to PrintVIS to have a bit better explanation of the role center. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump into my cases. Let's look at an existing quotation. So let's look at this quote for the Bond magazine for Sportsmayer's furnishings. Now, you'll notice that Sportsmayer's asked for a 24-page and 32-page magazine quoted in different quantities, 5,000, 7,500, 10,000, 15,000. It's pretty easy to do this in PrintVIS because what I would normally do is I would pick one size, I'd fill one line in for one quantity with one of the sizes, and then I would copy it, change the size and quantities on each copy. Very, very easy and quick to do. I'm going to go into this active quote here for 7,500 of the 24 page, and I'm going to look at the job card for this quote. And what this is going to do is this is going to tell me the three pages I need to print, or in PrintVIS terminology, sheets that I'm going to be printing on my presses. I have a cover sheet and two text sheets that I'm going to be doing. So on my cover, I'm doing a four-page cover on 80-pound satin. And if I look at my sheets and signature, I have one quarter of a sheet and a signature, meaning that there are four signatures on this sheet. So this is a four up of covers. I look at my text. I have my next 16 pages because this is a 24 page. I have 16 pages of text. And there is this is on 70 pound satin without aqueous. And that's one signature. And then finally, I have text. I have my last eight pages of text that I need to print. That's going to be a half signature per sheet, meaning I have two up on that sheet. The next thing I can look at for this is I can actually take a look at this job. Let me close that. I can look at what my estimate is calculated based on the production of those three. So, and by the way, I'm producing those, I believe, on a Heidelberg Speedmaster, an L5230. For the cover of L5230 is, oh, it's a KBA Rapida, and the others are on the 5110, which is, the 5110 is my Heidelberg Speedmaster. So I have, it's also a 4x4, and I can tell whether this will be a work in turn or if it's got a perfector in it, depending on different settings and configurations. I can also look at information about things like my sheet and my specification, which will give me an outline of information about, for instance, the paper. Here's my work in turn printing method, where I have my quantity, my scrap, my gross printed sheets that I require, the job item I'm producing on this one, an imposition page to show me sort of a graphical representation of what the imposition will look like. This is meant for an approximation as opposed to being used as impositioning software. You still need your other software for doing that properly. And there's a whole variety of different information that I can get from my quote once I've created it, including I can take a look at what the different processes are that I'm going to need to run in the production in order to produce all my materials, all the different processes I'm doing, my glue binding, my speed master, my trimming, et cetera, et cetera. Everything that needs to be done in order to do this. So let's close this back out. I have an estimate, and in my estimate, I have a price calculated based on direct costs and contribution margins. I can click on the direct cost, and I will get a drill down of all of the individual costs that went in based on quantities, hours, rates. In this case, if it's hours, this will be my rate per hour. My additional cost, which is going to be my contribution, and then I have something called a self-cost price, which is, in essence, my absorbed cost price. And then I can put additional overheads on top. And then I can have a selling price, a price I charge the customer. And so I the system is going to give me a very, very detailed breakdown of all of the information. And I can click open in Excel, and I can open this information right in an Excel sheet so that I can analyze it any way I want, slice and dice it using your traditional Excel features and functionality right out of the system that quick and easy. So all of the information regarding all the costs that went into calculating this magazine are all in this sheet. Very easy for you to access. I have what my contribution margin is and a contribution margin ratio. I have my net profit that's expected and what my margin is on that net profit. This is a margin-based system. I could decide I want a 15% margin, and when I do that, I've changed my price method to fixed profit percent from calculated. If I change it back to calculated, everything will revert to what it was originally. If I decide that I want to have a quoted price, I want to quote $87.50 to them, then it'll tell me it's a fixed quote price for the job. If I want to make the contribution margin $4,800, it'll recalculate my quoted price again and say my contribution margin is locked. So every time I change something on the screen, this price method adjusts to account for what I've changed. The price, the ultimate quoted price that comes up here, is going to replace the price that the system calculated and determined, and that's based on your business's requirements and rules of thumb. So now let's say $9,065 is my quoted price for this. If I now close this and go back to my cover page of my quote, I'm going to see that $9,060 quoted price, $9,065 quoted price, with a little indication on the screen to tell me that this was me changing the contribution margin to bring it up to this price. Whereas all the rest of them are using the calculated price, as you can see on the screen. So this is an existing quote in PrintVIS. Let's build one from scratch and just see how easy this is. So here I am in my 12-page plus cover that I started during my last demo video, but I didn't finish. And I've started filling in the information for the quote. So let's just say 12-page plus cover. We're going to put $2,500 in with a 5% over delivery maximum, allowing us to have a quantity of $2,625. And we're going to make this a 12-page, 8.5x11 format, 4-color front, 4-color back. And the system's automatically come up with a quote for us because we've basically had the system automatically calculate the labor and ink and materials that would be required for it, less the paper, because we haven't defined paper yet. So to define paper, we go in and we manage the job card. And from here, we're given the opportunity to choose our cover and our text. So let's go through here, and we're going to try and find our paper weight. Let's do an 80-pound And let's do a 80-pound silk. So there's a creator silk cover. We'll do a 25 by 38. And we'll run this on our Heidelberg Speedmaster. Put it on L5110. So now what we have is you'll notice that our price has automatically gone up quite a bit now from the $500 that we originally had, because we've chosen our substrate. There we go. So let's use our 23 by 35 70-pound silk text and see what happens. What's occurred automatically is, because of the 12-page, we need to impose another sheet in order to produce all of the pages that we need for our text. So we're going to have 8 pages on the first, and we're going to have a 2-up, and then we're going to have 4 pages on the second text, and we're going to have a 4-up. Let's take a look now that I filled that in. Let's also take a look at the estimating, which is a breakdown basically of the operations and information that goes into the estimate with all of the details, which the example that we exported to Excel, but broken down into a different view. So what I have at the top of the screen is I have all of the what are called cost units, the equipment or operations that I need to conduct in order to make this. And at the bottom, I have a breakdown of the selected one. So if I click on soft proofing, I have a fairly short 3-item list, file retrieval, placement of file, and process answer, for which I've calculated a little bit of time for each. So there's a little tiny bit of cost associated with my soft proofing here. It's about $40. If I go to my DTP operations, my desktop publishing, now I've got a little bit more choices here, including Photoshop and placing aligning pictures, etc. And I have some InDesign time for 16 pages total, which has basically brought me up to about 1.5 hours roughly of time that I'm going to be spending to go over the files and make sure they're okay, which I'm going to charge $229 to do. So as you can see, I could, though, and I have no other costs or anything else, but if the customer had said, you know what, I need some Photoshop work, can you help me with that? I could put in 2 hours of Photoshop for the customer. And that will now be something I've added to the quote, which will automatically also go through that department. So the desktop publishing department will have that as a task now assigned to them. If I clear this, if I click this button, it'll clear out what I've added. So this is the manual hours, meaning if I've typed something in and overridden the hours manually, or if I type in a quantity and override it manually, then that's going to automatically fill that in and I can uncheck it to return it to whatever it was originally. So if I say this customer always causes a problem, I'm going to charge them 3.2 hours for the desktop publishing time because they've always been lots of errors. I just uncheck that and it goes back to the default that was based on the template and on the calculations. I have my plate making. I have information about the plates, the setup for plate production of plates, the file saved. I have my paper for my Speedmaster. These are the 3 papers that I chose, or the 3 sheets that are going to be produced. And then I actually have my production for my Speedmaster. So the P underscore is the paper, and the 5110 is the actual Speedmaster. And here I have setup time, color blending if I had a Pantone color, plate adjustments, printing, etc. And then my ink usage with the number of, I believe this is in pounds, yes it is, it's in pounds, number of pounds of ink that I'm expecting to use. That covers off most everything regarding the estimating within the PrintVIS system. Obviously, there's a lot more depth to it than what I've just shown. Thank you for your time today. Please reach out to us at sabrelimited.com for contact information and to ask any additional questions. And look for more videos coming soon on PrintVIS and other products. Thank you.